Bande Guru Pada Tandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nityananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijano Samayuktam Binda Vāñcā kalpa taru vascha kipāsindu vivacha patitānaṁ pāvanibhva vaiṣṇavibhyo namo namah mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgūṁ laṅghaita giriṁ yat kipātamahaṁ bandhi paramānanda mādhavam brindhāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasaja śṇa bhakti vade devi sattva-bhattvai namo namah Narayana Namaskritta Narancaiva Narottama Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Kauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varunya Dhyam sada paribhavagnam avishtaduham tethas padam siva virenjanutam saranyam bhetatiham panutapalabhavadiputam bande mahapurushate charana ravindam yat pad pallavanakachandam anichatai bispurijitagamapigapodushuadarshi Purnanuragara-sasagara-sara-murti Saradhikamayikadankipamkarusa Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Advaita Gadadharasivasadihi Gaurabhaktavinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Siyadvaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siyadvaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Ajanu lambita bhujau kanaka bodhato, Sankirtanai kapitaru kamala yutaksho, Visham varo dijavaro jugadharma palo, Bande yagat priya karo, Karuna Bhutaru Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibba Rupam Bhuktin Cha Muktin Cha Dada Sinitam Bhavan Rupena Sada Naranam Ganga Taranga Ramaniya Jata Kalapam Gauri Nirantara Vibhushi Tobam Bhagam Narayano Priyamananga Madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatam Vagi Shajusha Badane Lakshmi Jasacha Bhakshasi Jasyasti Hide Sambhihir Tvam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 कल्पतरुर्गलितं फलं सुखमदा सुखमुखाद् अमृतदवसंयुतं पीबतो भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुविभावुकः निगमो कल्पतरुर्गलितं फलं सुखमुखाद् अमृतदवसंयुतं पीबतो भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुविभावुकः गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी जगत भोपाल जगद्गुरु लास्ट टाइम व्हेन ही वाज इन पुरी चटक पर्वत ही टोल्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ विनोद बिहारी प्रभु नो मोर पीपल कैन अंडरस्टैंड माय सिद्धांत विचार. They are not ready to accept those Siddhanta Vichar, pure Siddhanta Vichar. So what I can do by staying here anymore? Gaudiya Goshthipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Prabhupada Jagadguru told one time, he was in Puri last time, last Puri visit, Chatak Parvat, he was sick, manifesting sick Leela. In front of Vinodda, Vinod Prabhu is speaking. No more people can understand my Siddhanta Vichar. They are not ready to accept this pure Siddhanta Vichar. What I can do by staying here more? Those pure devotees, those Mahajan, they coming here to help us to understand pure Siddhanta Vichar, they help us to go ahead in bhajan line. But there is so much confusion because if same teachings not coming to you through parampara, in that case, parampara vaibhav is in danger. These are not question of fighting. This is not the time of infighting. This is a question of survival of our own sampradaya, Saraswat Gauriya Sampradaya. It is not the time for infighting. It is a question of survival of our total sampradaya. Many times before I told, if my attention is unto the lotus feet of Anantadev, till then I cannot lose my patience to make you understand. Maybe you can go against me. I can never lose my patience to make you understand. I know you cannot believe me because I am not international speaker. Those who are international speaker, they can speak lie, they can give you enjoyment, you are bound to accept it. Whereas 100% I can challenge, I can speak about their absolute truth, but you are not ready to accept. You can say no, it cannot be so, because I am not international speaker. This is the fallacy. This way all in preaching field, so many garbage gathered already. I have also no time to go for altercation, fighting. Rather, I also like to leave this material world. I don't like to leave more. The situation is very typical. Nobody ready to accept. If I can prove mathematics, if I can prove like mathematics, Prabhu, see, this is this, Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, this is Siddhanta, so it cannot be so. Still they can say, we cannot obey you. We can obey them. So I have nothing to do. What I can do? There is a time when we should get together is a question of survival of our total sampradaya. Keep patience, like to hear. If you find any thing which is not scientific, then you can chase me. totally on the basis of Shastra Siddhanta I am speaking. You are not in front of me sitting. You are sitting long away. If you are in front of me, I would like to put some question in front of you. I like to get answer from you. So if I can get yes answer, is logic actually. Somebody don't like to believe me, so first try to get yes answer. Prabhu, this is okay? Yes. This is okay? Yes. Then I can allow you to speak yes, ultimately. Otherwise you can go on argument. Now my question is that, Gurupad Padmasila Sanatana Goswami Pad, Jagat Guru, Rupa Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, Raghunath Das Goswami, they all trying their best to give all secret treasures of bhajan. Who is going to see? New philosophy manufactured, you like to see. You have no time to go through Jaiva Dharma even. Clearly. Repeatedly you will have to go through Jaiva Dharma, Sikshamitra, so that you can understand. What I am speaking, if you have no basic conception, then you can go on hearing on the basis of your logical mood. Top to bottom, try to understand, it is not the question of criticism. It is the main and vital point in bhajan that one Vaishnava cannot criticize other. It is prohibited, it is strictly prohibited. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Vaishnava charitra sadai pavitra. Vaishnava charitra, you cannot find any fault with any Vaishnava. It is always pure. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if somebody out of jealousy, out of envious attitude going to criticize, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhakti Vinod Nasamba se sare sada thake mauno dhori. Bhaktivinoda speaking, he don't like to speak with that man. He like to keep silence, maintain silence mood. Bhakti Vinod Nasamba says, I don't like to speak with him, don't like to see his face. Who is Vaishnava, who is not, who is in which condition? What is the condition of this Vaishnava? What stage? I cannot pass any rubbish remark unnecessarily without understanding. That's why this Brihad Bhagavatamrita is very important. We can try to understand that what is the humble mood. Humble mood doesn't mean I can stop speaking about that absolute truth. Prabhupada speaking, Kai mone vakye kare udbeg na dibo. By body, speech and mind, we should not give any pain to anybody. Put pressure on anybody. Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking, by the help of this sloka, undue advantage we can take and we can prove that we should not speak about that absolute truth. Prabhupada speaking, why you stop speaking about that absolute truth, absolute way? Why you are going to stop speaking about that absolute truth, absolute way? Bhagavan died? Anantadev is not there? Anantadev not watching? Who is doing what? He is watching? So better if we can look, if our attention is unto the lotus feet of Anantadev, then some prejudicial idea or narrowness or simply my society and this, I can think about this kind of conception cannot come. If our attention is unto the lotus feet of Anantadev, in that case this kind of prejudicial conception, biased conception or some narrowness cannot arise. Sanatana Goswami Pada is Jagat Guru, about whom next Harikatha I can speak. What kind of heart is there? What kind of heart, soft heart there inside Sanatana Gosai, Rupa Gosai Path, Sanatana Gosai Path, everybody. Bhakti Prabhupada, Bhakti Minu Thakur, all Bhakti Gumat Puri Gishri Maharaj, their heart is so soft that even we cannot compare it with butter. Still, I have seen somebody criticizing. But when Guru Maharaj hearing, Guru Maharaj not expressing any reaction. Somebody passing Nimma, foolish people, they are saying that he is enjoying the kippah of that Sisilas, this Maharaj. But I know, kripa is not such easy thing. Prabhu, I cannot cheat you. I promise you, I cannot cheat you. Kripa is not such an easy thing. Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to get 1 kilometer lengthy, if you are going to get 1 kilometer lengthy title, if you are going to get 1 kilometer lengthy title about your Vaishnavism, but still there is no surety that Bhagavan going to look at you. Foolish people can shout and give slogan. What it concerned to Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur? It's not a matter of joke. They don't understand bhakti, what is bhakti. They don't understand what is, you know, Vaishnavism, what is humbleness. And they don't understand it. You know, Suddha Bhakti Tattva, Guru Tattva, they don't understand. Only assumption. They go on hearing. And sometimes, they can, time to time, they can attack. Prabhupada speaking, their platform on which they are at present standing, the platform on which at present they are standing cannot allow them to understand the topics which a great Vaishnava going to discuss. Because his platform is totally different, Vaikuntha platform. And our platform is actually material platform. Maybe some advance. I go some up. Maybe I can understand some fine philosophy. Up to this point I reach. I understand fine philosophy. I can speak fine philosophy. That doesn't mean I am enjoying full kippah of Guru Varga. The symptom of kippah is that kippah can melt your heart. Kippah cannot allow you to find fault with others. Gurupad Padma, actually, somebody coming and saying, Maharaj, this Maharaj speaking, passing this kind of remark, that you are a Kanishtha devotee, you know, and is crying, all devotee. Guru Padmanabha, why you are crying? I thought I have no position. He is at least speaking that I have Kanishtha Adhikar, Archan. At least he is, and I am very grateful to him. Follow what I say. And Guru Puja doesn't mean, if you note in diary what I am speaking, time to time you can ask me, I can show you from where I am speaking, how I am speaking. Prabhupada speaking, Guru Puja doesn't mean only Guru Puja. Gurupad Padma speaking in his article also, but I am speaking about Prabhupada. Because maybe you can say, you can speak what your Guru is speaking. Because it's the age of altercation, fighting. Prabhupada speaking, Guru Puja, only Guru Puja is not Guru Puja. Saparsat Guru Puja. Those who are serving Prabhupada for a long time, they are giving their life and soul, everything for Prabhupada, all money, position, honor, everything they have given. I know it for sure. Not everybody fighting. Those who are fighting inside Gauriya Math, they are not in Gauriya Math. Like Dham Tattva Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, in Dham, somebody speaking, there is hotel, there is cross quarter here. Bhaktivinoda, no! No, it is on the net, arranged by Maya. In Dham, Sridham Mayapur, Sridham Vrindavan, there cannot be in a hotel or cross quarter. Cannot be. They are all there on a net arranged by Maya Devi. So he cannot speak this way, there is fighting inside Gauriya Math. I can prove, you come to me. There is no fighting, only Seva. Those who are fighting, they already get lost, got lost already. They are not enjoying Kripa Prabhupada. But those who are dedicated soul, they are doing so much service day and night. They have no, they got no time to sleep. Those Guru Bharga, excellent Guru Bharga, genius Guru Bharga, we should give all the time. All our Guru Bharga used to speak, my Guru Maharaj also used to speak daily. You will have to glorify one Vaishnava, and Ramanujacharya speaking, every day you will have to glorify your Guru Pad Padma. Ramanujacharya speaking, every day you will have to speak. If you stop speaking about the topics of Guru Pad Padma, if you are going to speak about your own topics, then you can lose bhakti. Ramanujacharya, it was published in Gauriya. So only Guru Puja is not Guru Puja. Only Guru Puja is not Guru Puja. Every morning you will have to sing. Sujanar Buddha Radhito Pada Jugam. You will have to sing daily in the morning. Why not singing? Every day you will have to sing. This way, scientifically I can prove that how we should approach. Otherwise, Dear Bhagavad-gita, what we can do with Dear Bhagavad-gita? We cannot understand bhakti tattva, bhakta tattva, we cannot understand. Prabhupada speaking, only Guru Puja is not Guru Puja. Saparsat Guru Puja is Guru Puja. If you lose the temperament to receive Saparsat Prabhupada, then you are going to lose your patience. Surely your attention is not unto lotus feet of Anantadev. If my attention is there unto lotus feet of Anantadev, this kind of narrowness cannot come. Impossible. Vital point is that many times a heart for your Guru Bharga and in Shastra, top to bottom in the from the very beginning up to end of your life, or even in Nitya Jagat, if you are at all going to enter. All top to bottom, everything depend upon your Guru Kipa. Gaurya Bhajan is Vipralamba Bhajan. Whole day and night we have to cry in the name of Guru Vaishnava. Oh, kipa karo, I am powerless, I have no, I am going to fall down, please save me. All the time you have to cry. Gauriya Bhajan is a bhajan of Vipralamba. Gauriya Bhajan is not a bhajan of jealousy. All the time Vipralamba, I have done nothing. I have done nothing, what I have done? I was supposed to do, but I couldn't do. I am powerless. I have no quality. Humbleness all the time. See the quality of Harikatha. If you have no biasness, you will have to go through the quality of Harikatha. Who is speaking what kind of quality? Because Harikatha, transcendental Harikatha, coming from transcendental Babot, it's not, you know, one kind of, you know, judgment, simple material judgment. So I can go on speaking. Like Gauranga Mahaprabhu, if I worship, I will have to worship Saparsat Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Similarly, if I like to worship Gurudev Prabhupada, I will have to worship Saparsat. Even Srila Bhaktivallabha Titta Goswami used to speak, our Guru Maharaj, daily, Bharti Maharaj, at least daily, we will have to glorify one Vaishnava. Daily, one person like Banu Goswami Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami, all the time, one Vaishnava. You will have to read and you will have to glorify them. It is very powerful. You can get, you know, one day two of our Guru Bharga, they had some simple, you know, relation, little bit break. Immediately Prabhupada bring those two. One is Banu Goswami, another is I don't like to speak. Both of them, and Prabhupada sitting and speaking, you go on glorifying his name. He went on glorifying. After 1 hour, he's saying, you go on glorifying about him. This way, problem finished. And when Guru Tattva is the vital thing, top to bottom, when top to bottom, from the beginning up to end, even in Nitya Jagat, Guru, Shakti, Guru Bal is all. As and when I depend upon my own power, I can lose everything, all power, I can lose patience. Follow. Guru Bal and Guru Parampara. Yesterday also I told, if I am going to misguide about, if I am going to misguide you all, if I am going to misguide you all about your parampara, then I am going to lose my bhajan. Because if I am going to misguide you about Guru Parampara and the glories of Guru Parampara, then I am you know, actually great offender. Because on the basis of the power of Guru Parampara, on the faith, on the basis of the strong faith, on the basis of the strong faith of Guru Parampara, we can do bhajan. If somebody is going to help me to lose my faith in Guru Parampara, he is out of Gaudiya Sampradaya. He is enemy. He is just enemy. Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times told, na? Those in the guise of Gaudiya devotees, those who are going to think, going to speak that we are not in the line of, you know, Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, they are all, you know, great offender. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. If I am not going to give you strong faith, if I am not going to build up your strong faith in Guru Parampara, how then you can do bhajan? If parampara you think parampara useless, everything useless, then how you can get power? On the basis of this strong faith, we can do bhajan. I can give one material example. The civilization of Babylon, the civilization of Babylon, Mishore, was destroyed. The civilization of Babylon, civilization of Mishore was destroyed simply because of the fact that they could not keep faith on their hereditical factor, parampara. Hereditical glory, they couldn't keep faith. That's why the civilization was destroyed totally. But you look at India. You can look at India. If you can go through the history of India, hundreds of thousands of times, different kind of outside force coming to capture India, to fight with Indian people, to take them under control. They wanted to change their religion. They wanted to put oppression upon them. But still they couldn't do it perfectly. Because Indian heritage is Sanatana Dharma. It's Sanatana, not like other Dharma. It was built 3,000 years back. It was built 2,200 years back. Not that. Eternally there, Sanatana Dharma. So you can attack on me, you can attack on my Sampradaya, but you have nothing to do. Surely, Bhaktivinoda Dara can never be destroyed. It is the blessings of Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada. Bhaktivinoda Dara can never be destroyed. So the civilization of Babylon, Mishra was destroyed because simply they couldn't keep faith on their traditional hereditary factor, glories. If we lose our hereditary glories, if we lose our faith in hereditary glories, then we can lose all bhajan, whole sampradaya can come to an end, the flow of the sampradaya. What a great offense it is. It is not the question of my society, your society, come Saturday club, Sunday club, not that. It is the question of survival of whole sampradaya. Try to kick out of narrow conception and come on same platform to give protection. We cannot accept wrong siddhanta, wrong vichar. We cannot. Yesterday I was discussing about how Parikshit Maharaj going to offer his obeisance to Lord Siddhartha. Sukadev Goswami, Gurudev, to give the total of my heart. You know, If I can give 50% of my heart to my Gurudev, then I cannot do bhajan. I can give 50%, I can give 60%, I can 70%, 80%, even 90%. But I cannot give 100%. That is my... How you know? You come to me like mathematics. I can prove. He is speaking this, he is speaking this Siddhanta, he is doing this, his activities. And so Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda speaking, and in Shastra it is written, so it cannot be so. It cannot be so. I know you are not going to accept me because I am not international speaker. Even one international speaker speaking lie, never Bhaktivinoda told, Prabhupada told, still you say, no, it is true. Sambhava is wrong. But you cannot prove it. Out of your money power, manpower, you can put, you know, some problem. But you cannot prove. You cannot prove. So many, this kind of things happened already. So, this kind of, this way, the situation created, then now, if I am going to give my life and soul, all blood I am giving for this Gaudiya Sampradaya, still nobody going to cooperate with me. They are all busy with their own society and own protection of their own position and money. Nobody ready. They know 100%. The Sambhava are not going wrong way, but still they have no power. They cannot come. They cannot come. There is a situation, weakness. Weakness. So actually, it's very difficult position at present. Mutual distrust, mutual fighting, mutual this, it cannot allow us to go ahead in bhajan. And so I also am going to lose my desire. I have desire to live more. Day by day I see the situation. What I can do? And today onward, I like to avoid this kind of, you know, question. If somebody is in you, you go and get it, get the answer from anybody. Don't come to me, because I cannot speak lie. If you put question, I will speak, and I can give documents, but you cannot believe me. So then often, then there is great offense, I cannot give. You can go to somebody. You go to somebody and he can give answer. Very disgusting feeling. Parikshit Maharaj is going to give total heart unto the lotus feet of Sukadeva Goswami. If you are not going to give your heart, total heart, to Guru Pad Padma, then your hearing Harikatha is not complete. Any step you can make mistake, you can fall down. Because you are, your estimation mood cannot allow you to go advance, go ahead. You will have to give your life and soul unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, from where you are going to hear your Bhagavad Katha. Bhagavad Katha is just equal to Bhagavan himself. Harikatha is just equal to Hari. There is no scope that you can start fighting. If you have any dive, you come, I can prove. This much I can say. But with neutral mood you will have to come. Not with fighting mood. Parikshit Maharaj going to submit unto lotus feet of Sukadeva Goswami. Gurudev, I am just fed up. You please speak. So many guru speaking so many things. But the question of Parikshit Maharaj I already told you. Same thing Prabhupada told you yesterday, I was speaking. If I seek the path, try to remember. If I seek the path leading to that ultimate good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul. There cannot be thousands of guru. It's rare. Rare. From top to bottom, from beginning to end, if you do some scrutiny of the life of Guru Pad Padma, under the guidance of a very powerful acharya, who is tattvavid, he can show you mathematically. This is the thing. Why Prabhupada wanted to avoid selecting Guru Pad Padma? That doesn't mean nobody was qualified. Not that! Not that! Wrong Siddhanta! Wrong Siddhanta this is! Wrong Siddhanta! There are so many reasons. I already discussed before what can be the possible reason for why. Don't try to misuse this point. Always I like to elevate myself. I am everybody, all useless. It's not good. It's not good. It's not good. It is not Vaishnavism. Amani Manod. Always we like to glorify Guru Pad, Padma Guru Vaishnava all the time. You can go through all Abhirbhava and Thirabhava Guru Vaishnava. I have no partiality all the time I am speaking. Santo Goswami Maharaj, Siddha Goswami Maharaj, all the time. You can go. If it is prohibited, then surely you are not going to do bhajan. If it is strictly prohibited to glorify all the glories of Guru Vaishnava life, then surely we are not doing bhajan. Some material organization. What is the activities of material organization? What is the activities of Chaitanya Mahat and what is the activity of Gauriya Mahat? What is? You have to understand. Parikshit Maharaj with humble mood, because he is sure that I am going to leave my body, with full submission going to hear Harikatha. His mind is resting under the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, mean Anantadev. Guru Pad Padma Anantadev. Brahma Pramad Vipralipsa Karana Patap. Those are the four general mistake defects you can expect in material guru. Brahma, Pramad, Vipralipsa, Karna, Patab. Those are the four general defects you can expect in material guru. Those who are Siddha Mahatma, those who are Tathavid Guru, even you cannot find a slip of tongue. Even you cannot discover any slip of tongue. They are so Siddha. They are each and every word is measurement there. They are always glorifying Guru Vaishnava, Guru Parampara. If I cut the relationship, Parampara and Gurudev, Guru Parampara is the main object of our bhajan, through which I can get power. Otherwise I cannot get power. Like material organization I can run. I can run like material organization, nothing else. Nothing else, nothing. When Sukhdev Goswami is going to give answer, I already told, the only way, and some 15 days before I was discussing, Baba speaking, if we are failure, Baba speaking, if we are failure to protect, if we are failure to protect the fire of Sankirtan Jagya, as was enlightened by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Siva Sangam, if we are failure to protect the Sankirtan Jagyagni, flame of Sankirtan Jagyagni, as was protected by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, they all wanted to protect the Sankirtan Jagyagni. If we fail, if we are deviated from the track of Guru Bhakti Padma, then all different kind of jealousy, partiality, all pratishthasa, all different kind of garbage, I mean, can come to contaminate our heart and can make us fall down. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada speaking. We can lose our patience. We can lose our patience. Follow. We can go on speaking all rubbish that is not written in Shastra. No Shastra, naya. I told you, just Prabhupada speaking. Where it is written, you come to me, I can show you. Even 1 kilometer lengthy title you can get. So much, you know, Abhishek, so much, you know, title. But that doesn't mean that you are enjoying full Guru Kripa. There is some symptom, like cholera or malaria. If there is typhoid, I am doing treatment of malaria. It's not good. All disease, there is some symptom. Pure Guru Vaishnava, the Tattvavid Guru, they can arrest you. They don't know. They know everything, you don't know. They know. On the basis of their tathavid, they can speak. This is a symptom. Foolish people can start infighting only. This is their benefit. Day by day, they are losing discussion of, you know, all Tattva Siddhanta, everything. They like to forget Prabhupada. Bhakti Siddhanta. If they can forget Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, this is very good. Otherwise, their, you know, maintenance is very tough. Sometimes they pass this kind of remark. Oh, Maharaj, you know, at present, if we are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Thakur, we cannot maintain Gauriya Math. I say, you are not the member of Gauriya Math. You go to home. Gauriya Math don't need your help. Gauriya Math transcendental. Gauriya Math don't need. I have money, I can make some Gauriya Math. Not that. By the invitation of Prabhupada, Gauriya Math can come only. Not that. They have money power, they can open one Gauriya Math. They are all different kind of, you know, wrong activities going on. Very dirty activities. Only name and fame. I, you know, this is my society motto. So, neutral platform, you have to stand on neutral platform to understand the message of Prabhupada. The message of Prabhupada means the message of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Exactly. The message of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You have to understand. So actually, Prabhupada speaking, if we are failure to protect the Sankirtan Yajnagni, then we can be busy with some personal interest and anartha, different kind of anartha and problem can come and contaminate our heart and can make us fall down. That's why all the 24 hours we'll have to sing the glories of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur all the time. My Guru Padmadma, each and every fraction of second, used to speak, Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Sridhar Goswami, all the time, Prabhupada, Prabhupada, all the time. All the time, you will have to. Otherwise, who can give protection? Someday I can speak the symptoms of Sadguru spoken by Prabhupada, I can speak someday. Now, today, no time. So now, point is that Guru Pad Padma, going to Guru Pad Padma, going to glorify disciple. Can you imagine? When Guru Pad Padma going to glorify disciple, excellent moment. When Guru Pad Padma and sister totally harmonized. If you fail, yesterday I was speaking about adjustment with Sun God. If you are not foolish, then you can realize what I mean to say. Prabhupada wanted to speak how to adjust with Sun God. Now, we, by the mercy of Bhagavan, we are now in safe distance, you know, very, you know, suitable distance we can maintain with Sun God. So, Sun God can send hot, you know, heat to us, heat energy. We can save our lives, not too near to Sun God, not too far to Sun God. Adjusted distance. There should be all proper adjustment with the Sun God, so that we can see the Sun God, and by the mercy of Sun God, we can discover all, everything, and by the mercy of Sun God, we can get all sunlight to protect our life, everything. We can do all our daily job, everything. Everything is possible by the suitable distance maintained by Supreme Lord. Sun God and this earth. There is a safe distance between us, between Sun God and we. There is a safe distance. Similarly, try to understand the mood of Prabhupada. If you are at all a nice devotee, then you will have to understand the adjustment with Guru Pad Padma, Guru Varga. If you fail to adjust with Guru Varga and try to indicate fault, that means you are defaulter. Fault, only fault. Cannot find any quality. If there is weakness in me, Then I can speak all rubbish against my guru, God brothers. They can do some rubbish against me. Still I cannot see. But indirectly I can speak. This is the instruction by Supreme Lord. Bhagavan saying in Bhagavat 11th canto 21 chapter. Veda Brahmatmaka Vishaya Srikanta Vishaya Ime. What writing? Veda Brahmatma Vishaya Srikanta Vishaya Ime Paraksha Bhada Risayoho Parakshancha Mama Priyam. Krishna speaking. The Vedas divided into three divisions, ultimately rebel, worship of the Lord, ultimately going to indicate the lotus feet of the Lord. Vedascha sarvai rahameva vedya. Vedascha sarvai rahameva vedya. The Vedas divided into three divisions. Ultimately, Vedas going to show the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Tadvishyam paramam padam sadapa swanti surayo divibho chakshuratatam. Rigved mantra. The Vedic sages and mantras, those Vedic sages and mantras, however, state this indirectly. The Vedic sages and mantras, however, state everything indirectly, since they could realize that Krishna like indirect procedure, indirect method. Krishna always like indirect method. That's why Guru Vaishnava not going to chase anybody directly. Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, they all Rishi Mani, they are all speaking indirectly so that you can have the chance to rectify you. Directly it's not possible to speak all the time. Sometime powerful Guru Vaishnava speaking directly to rectify our painful situation. The Vedic sages and mantras, however, state anything and everything of Siddhanta Vichara Vedas indirectly, since they could realize that Krishna prefer this indirect procedure. Because they could realize Krishna prefer the indirect method. So no harm in it. If there is plain heart, out of mercy, out of abnormal mercy, is somebody going to speak Shastra Siddhanta and speaking indirectly the situation, everything, it is not aparad. It is not offense, because they have no jealousy. They are paramahansa, they are tattvabhid. They only want to rectify the situation. I can remind you one point. One Siddhanta Vichara Bhaktivinoda Thakur. One Babaji Maharaj from Navadvip. One Babaji Maharaj from Navadvip almost daily going to Krishnagar to file one case against somebody. Every day, one Babaji Maharaj, almost every day going to Krishnagar, chanting Harinam and going to Krishnagar almost daily and going to file one case against somebody, one or somebody. And all devotees of Sahajiya, Navadvip, Sahajiya group, they approach Bhaktivinoda Thakur and they complain against that Babaji Maharaj. They are speaking, "You are district magistrate, please try to do justice with us. That Babaji Maharaj almost daily going to Krishnagar, coming to you and file one case against one or somebody every day. He is not doing bhajan. This is his bhajan. Not doing bhajan. Please, you know, check that Babaji Maharaj. Try to check his activities." Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing and speaking, "Babaji Maharaj is merciful. Babaji Maharaj cannot tolerate that you all are doing some babicha, all rubbish activities. In the name of Babaji, you are taking the association of widow. You are going to take the properties of Bhagavan. You are going to take. You are going to take control over some land illegally. It's Bhagavat property. That's why almost every day, Babaji is coming and filing one case against one or somebody. It is bhakti for him. Bhakti Mata was speaking. It is bhakti for him. It is bhakti. You are not doing bhakti. You are only sitting in a solitary place, and night time you are doing all babichar, useless activities, and day time you are sowing, going to sow. You are big Vaishnava. You are chanting. Some devotee, so-called devotee in Govardhan, Vrindavan, someday he was you know, out of jealousy, he was bound to pass this kind of remark. In relation, his godbrother, he is speaking this way. Sam Baba, no activity. He is writing so protest on this, that. Some devotee spoke, it is his bhakti. Bharati Maharaj told openly in the assembly of Prabhupada Abhirbhav Tithi. Openly, I was not there. That you will have to go through the writings written by Sam Baba. His bhakti. His right, doing seva pa sampradaya. But all other people, they like to prove that they are actually nice Vaishnava. They are involved. They don't like to go for fighting. They like to prove this way. They are great Vaishnava. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur not speaking this way. You will have to protect the sampradayic interest. It is your bhakti. You are sitting in a room calculating your deposit money and how, where to invest what money is calculating. You come out of room. Come out of room and speak Harikatha and try to give the full protection of Siddhanta Vani. That is the only duty of an Acharya. Acharya cannot mislead whole world. Acharya cannot mislead. Acharya can speak the truth. It's a duty, Prabhupada speaking. The vital duty, the only duty of an Acharya is to give full protection to Sarva Vani. Sampradayik Vaibhav. So this way, Bhakti Mata was speaking, Babaji Maharaj doing bhajan. He cannot tolerate that you all are doing some, you know, all wrong activities, very great offensive activities you are doing. So Babaji Maharaj is coming and filing one case. It is his bhakti. But your sitting inside a solitary room, solitary castle, and doing Harinam is not bhakti. It is Namaparad. Vaishnava Ninda is also Namaparad. He cannot do Harinam. You can go through the 10 principles of Namaparad. Dasavidha Namaparad, you can go. You can go through that, you know. There you can find Satam Ninda, Sadhu Aparad is giving the first preference, topmost. If I am going to do Sadhu Aparad, Sadhu Ninda, criticism, then one Harinam cannot come. One Harinath cannot appear on my tongue if I do Vaishnava Aparad. But if I am doing Siddhanta Vichar, if I am in line with Prabhupada and Bhakti, nobody can stop me doing Harinam. Nobody can stop me doing it. They can shout whatever they like, they can speak. Main Siddhanta is there. Those who are going to criticize those pure Guru Vaishnava, they can never be excused. They can never be excused. They can never be excused. Be careful. So you see, Parakshabad, indirectly, if somebody is speaking about Shastra Siddhanta, to check the downfall of the situation, in our society, it is not aparad. It is not offensive. It is not bad. Follow. Sometime, Guru Padmapadma is going to speak some glories of Sissa, sometime going to cheat, as sometime going to speak from heart. If I am not harmonized with the heart of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Kesava Maharaj, then I cannot speak Harikatha. I cannot, if I have some separate desire, I cannot speak Harikatha. If I have some secret desire to collect money, position, honor, then I cannot speak Harikatha. I cannot speak, not possible. Harikatha cannot appear onto my mouth, not appear. So Guru Mukha Padma Bhakya Hidayat Kariya Aikya Arna Kariya Manyasha. So Guru Mukha Padma Bhakya, when we can harmonize with Guru Padma, his heart, totally harmonize, dovetailed, totally harmonize, then possible. Then Prabhupada speaking, totally harmonize you will have to. In that case, you can realize Siddhanta Vichar. Out of your merit, out of your material merit, you cannot understand any Shastra Siddhanta. First of all, you will have to get Sadguru in your life. 100% sure Sadguru. Who is 24 hours busy? Who is 24 hours busy to serve Supreme Lord? Sabde Parechani Snatam. Sabde Parechani Snatam, who is versed in Sabda Brahma, who is feeling tremendous affinity, attraction for Parabrahma, loveful attraction. This is a symptom of Guru Padma. Follow. Sabde Parechani Snatam, Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Kipa Sindhu Susang Purno Sarva Satto Pakarakaha Nispriyo Sarvatoha Siddho Sarva Vidya Visharada Sarva Sansaya Sanshtitta Analasa Guru Rahita. The topmost definition of Guru Tattva. Who can cut any kind of down? Only not that. If you can force me to believe that our Guru Varga is nothing, all useless, then why you cannot force to be, you know, to rectify the situation by speaking this title? Why? In that case, you have no power. This way, Sukhdev Goswami is going to glorify disciple Parikshit Maharaj. To Parikshit Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami speaking from heart. Hey Rajan, your question is unparalleled, unbeaten. Baryan esote prashno. Baryan esote prashno krito loko hito nipaha. Baryan esote prashno krito loko hito nipaha. Atmavit sanmataha pungsam sotobhyadishu japaraha. Sukhdev Goswami, Paramahansa Shrestha, is the topmost Paramahansa speaking to Sukhdev Goswami, the disciple, Parikshit Maharaj, the disciple. Hey Rajan, your question is excellent question. This kind of question we expect. This kind of question we expect, why not coming? Baryane sate prasno, your question is topmost question. Baryane sate prasno kito loko hito nipaha. For the benefit of the whole world, you are going to put this kind of question to me. I like this question, my heart get melted. Baryane sate prasno kito loko hito nipaha. And it is approved by all tattvabhit. It is approved by all tattvabhit. Atmabhit samnataha pungsham. Atmabhit samnataha, those who are great atmabhit, They approve your this kind of question. Sometimes we are so clever. At the time of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta, we are not going to express our heart clearly that I am a demon. Sometimes we are not going to express our heart in front of Keshav Goswami Maharaj. We like to expose we are very, you know, great devotee. After they gone, I am going to express so dirty Siddhanta. Are they gone? Who can check? Nobody going to check? Keshav Goswami Maharaj was a topmost personality who used to check the downfall of the Sampradaya, he used to protest all the time. Keshav Goswami Maharaj not doing aparad. Even he is going to write a strong note to Ram Narayan Vidyaratna, the so-called Vaishnav and Pandit of Radharaman Press, Murshidabad, first press, after India was free, first press from England came, Petal Press, to Radharaman Press there in Murshidabad, North Bengal. Raja Manindu Chandra Rai was the king of that place, and Ram Narayan Vidyaratna, he was the editor of Radharaman Press, a topmost pandit of that time. But he is making some mistake, because they are not tattvavid sadhu, they are not realized soul, maybe they have some panditta, that's why they are writing. Kesa Goswami are writing in such a way, I cannot speak in front of you. Keshav Goswami Maharaj, I can show you Bengali. You come to me, I can show you. Keshav Goswami Maharaj saying, my brother, I think you have not gone through any Vyakaran ABCD. Keshav Goswami writing, going to insult that man because he has done some mistake in Haribhakti Vilas Siddhanta. Keshav Goswami writing, my brother, I think you have no ABC knowledge of Vyakaran. How you become Pandit? You are making mistake and misguiding people. This is called Keshav Goswami Maharaj, who is enjoying full kripa of Prabhupada. Follow. So, Atmavit Samnadha Pungsam. If your dialogue, if your harikatha, if your lecture, if your writing not approved by Atmavit Guru Vaishnav, then surely it has got no value. Only you can circulate in your society. Those who are tattvavid, they can never touch it. Follow what I say. Because they know it's here. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj can touch one writing and speak, this is wrong. Bhakti Pumapuri Vyasa Guru Maharaj can touch, and but they cannot speak. Because they don't like to fight. So, Atmavit Sanmataha Pamsha. Sukhdev Goswami speaking to Parikshit Maharaj, hey Rajan, Baryane Sote Prashna, your question is excellent. Baryane Sote Prashna, Krito Loka Hito Nipaha. You have done everything for the total benefit of the whole world. That is the heart of a pure Vaishnav. They are always going to do something for the whole world. Not any jealousy, nothing. They are always thinking about everybody. They are not thinking about own society. They are thinking about the whole Brahmanda. Brahmanda tarite shakti dhare jani jani. Brahmanda tarite shakti dhare jani jani. All Brahmanda. One Brahmanda they can purify. Provided I have no jealousy, no fighting mood with them. Provided I can harmonize with them. So now, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking. Baryane Sate Prashna, hey Rajan, Baryane Sate Prashna, Kito Loko Hito Nipaha, Atmavit Sanmataho Pungsham. It is approved, it is already approved by all Tathabid. All Tathabid, it is approved. Atmavit Sanmataho Pungsham, Shroto Badishu Joparaha. It is the topmost objective of hearing and speaking. Shroto Badishu Joparaha Adishu. Sravan, Kirtan, Smaran, Sotabhyadishu, Adishu, etc. Sotabhyadishu, Javaparaha. It is topmost, it can come to a topmost series of hearing and speaking and remembering. Sotabhyadishu. Same thing, here we find Uttara Devi, the mother of Parikshit Maharaj, going to ask this question, is going to put this question, Sanatana Goswami writing, Sukeno Padishtam Te Vatsa Nikrishya Tashame Sharam Prakasayo Khipram Khiram Bodher Ribamritam. Like the Kheer ocean was churned, by the churning of sea, Kira Sagar, by the churning of Kira Sagar, Amrita nectar was there, collected. Okay? Energy was given by demigods and demons, both. But you see, still, both of them, both of this group, those who are demon and those demigods, both of them giving energy. But when going to get result, demigods are successful and the demons are failure to collect. Why? If you find that partiality is there surely with Bhagavan, then you are wrong. Siddhanta there. Apparently, they are both of the group giving energy, but result, demigods, they are getting result of the energy, but the demon, they are going to lose the energy, going to lose everything. They are not getting nectar. Because, ohinam amrito yatha. You know, ohinam amrito yatha. Ohi matlab snack. If you give amrita, nectar to snack, if you give nectar to snack, it's not good. If you give nectar to snack, it's not good. Because the habit of a snack is to bite. So, Sasa Siddhanta should not be given to everybody. I am idiot number one. In my, you know, previous bhajan life, I was helping so many, you know, so-called devotees to get Siddhanta. Now they are doing business, they like to cut my throat. Follow? They learned something from me and they are doing business. But if I go, I can rectify the situation, then the whole group can go against me. Why you are going this, Maharaj? They are politicians. They can fight against me, unnecessary. They can make a group. I can lose my time. So I am not speaking as the lead. Bhagavan, I cannot give any punishment. Punishment always coming from up. I am bound to speak Satya Siddhanta because in front of me the question of sampradayik vaibhav involved. All previous, you know, generation, present generation, future generation, so I am bound to speak this way. So I am bound to speak this way, but I have no personal enmity with anybody. If I am not going to do, then it's great, great aparadh on my part. Because Bhagavan giving me power, so I will have to give. Follow what I say. This way, Atmavi Sanmadha Pungsam Sato Vyadi Sujaparaha, Sukhdev Goswami is going to appreciate that your question is so excellent. And Uttara Devi putting question, Devadacha, if somebody going to fight with me, why Maharaj, demigods and demons, they are all both of this group giving energy, why Bhagavan not going to give Amrita to demons? It is written in Shastra, Ohinam Amrito Yatha. To snack, it is strictly prohibited to give Amrita. Bhagavan also going to chide Brahma. Bhagavan, in 7th canto, you can find, 7th canto, you can find, when Hiranyakashipu gone, Nrisimhadev sitting, Prahlad Maharaj going to pacify Bhagavan, Prabhu, and Brahma also going to speak something, doing stava, and Bhagavan chiding to Brahma, Brahma! He should not give this kind of benediction to this kind of, you know, wicked personality like Hiranyakashipu. He should not give this kind of Ahinam Amrito Yatha. Similarly, everybody cannot digest Shastra Siddhanta. Everybody cannot digest Shastra Siddhanta, can make mistake in Siddhanta, because they are not in line with Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They like to get deviated. Follow. They can make mistake. So Uttaradevi is going to put question in front of son, Parikshit Maharaj, could you please make, could you please give me some cream of the discussion took place between you and, you know, Sukhdev Goswami. You please, out of that, if you can make some, if you can give me some cream, saram prakasaya khipram, very, very quickly, because you are going to leave your body. And here one word, nikrishyatashyame, sukeno padishtam, what you, what kind of advice, what kind of Bhagavad Katha you have heard from Sukadev Goswami. Like the cane juice, you know, to get cane juice, you will have to put all cane into a machine, and machine which is going to put pressure, roller going to put pressure on the cane, and juice coming out. So here this word, sukeno padishtam te vatsa nikrisho. Nikrisho means, you have to, you know, like cane juice, you have to nikrisho. Very vital thing you will have to, saram prakasayo, vital cream, very quickly you have to give, like the churning of that Kira Sagara, by the churning of Kira Sagara, there is Amrita. When Uttaradevi is going to put this question, then we have some judgment here, that what Uttaradevi want to say, what is the motive of Uttaradevi? Because Bhagavat, I already started with this sloka, nigama kalpa taror galitam phalam sukho mukhad amrita dava sanjutam pivata bhagavatam rasamalayam muhuraho rusika bhubi bhavuka. I can discuss this sloka someday, next time, next week, now no time. So pivata bhagavatam rasamalayam, follow up to the last breath of your life, go on drinking this nectar, this rasa. What is the outcome of nigama kalpa tarur galitam phalam? Galitam phalam, I can discuss next week. And is coming from the lotus mouth of Sukadev, sukha mukhad amrita dava sanjutam. Amrita dava sanjutam is already nectar. Why? It is already nectar. Why Uttaradevi is going to speak this way? I try to churn this Bhagavad Katha which you have heard and try to get some cream. What do you mean? Those who are going to write commentary, they are speaking, maybe it can be the ultimate desire of Uttaradevi, because time, they are left with very minimum time. Within that time, if Parikshit Maharaj can describe, then okay, otherwise, not possible. Maybe Uttaradevi wanted to speak, you try to collect Amrita in such a way from that Bhagavatam, so that you can represent the ultimate mode of bhakti. I mean, maybe Uttaradevi wanted to say the vital cream of total Bhagavatam is all Adya Rasa. I mean, Radhika Rani, Bhagavan Govindo, Bhagavan Krishna and Gopikas, their internal relationship and loveful affair. Maybe Uttara wanted to indicate, who knows? That's why maybe out of that Bhagavat, you know, you try to get Amrita. Are Bhagavat itself Amrita? So, this can be the meaning. Now, Parikshit Maharaj is very happy. Parikshit Maharaj speaking, oh my mother, I am supposed to leave my body. Minimum time left. Within that short interval, I was supposed to maintain silence vrata, mauna vrata. But when you come in front of me and going to put this kind of question, then, you know, I am overflowed with joy. My heart is overflowing. My heart is overflowing with joy. When you are putting this question, to speak Harikatha is also bhajan. To hear Harikatha is bhajan. To speak Harikatha is also bhajan. Topmost bhajan. Follow. So, it is like ocean. Kira ocean is like Bhagavatam. You know, Bhagavad Bhakti and Shastra. And Shastra is, you know, Shabda Brahma. Shastra is infinity. Anantaparam kila sabda shastram. Anantaparam kila sabda shastram. Shabda Shastra is endless. Where to go? Where to search? We are born a soul, going to die any time. There is no written certificate. There is no written certificate with us that we can start argument. We can live more 100 years. There is no surety. So better we can stop argument and go on hearing Harikatha. Stop fighting. Go beyond the limitation of your self-interest. Try to get in connection with Anantadev to get the cream. Otherwise you can lose everything. Shabda Brahma Sudur Bodham Pranandiyo Manomayam Anantaparam Gaviram Durvigayam Samudrabhat. Infinity ocean. Anantaparam Kila Sabda Sastram. In Bhagavatam, 11th canto, it is written, Shabda Brahma Sudur Bodham. Who can understand what is written? What is the inner meaning? Shabda Brahma Sudur Bodham Pranindriyo Manomayam. It can cover up, have some influence over heart and mind. Manomayam. Anantaparam. We cannot cross over this ocean. Anantaparam. Gambhiram is gravity. Very gravity, anantaparam gambhiram, durvigayam. We cannot, it is beyond measurement, fathomless. It is beyond measurement, fathomless. Like infinity ocean, where to go, how to go. We don't understand what is written in Shastra. Impossible, common people of this age of, you know, Kali, they are always busy with altercation. They have no power to understand Siddhanta Vichar or cream they cannot take. Always fighting mood. So you see, you know, top to bottom, Bhagavatam, Janvadasya Yato and Nayadita Rashchartha Savigya Sarada Tene Brahma, all from starting up to the end. Nama sankirtanam yasso sarva paapa punasanam pranama duksha samanam tang namami harim param. Nama sankirtanam yasso sarva paapa punasanam. Nama sankirtanam yasso sarva paapa punasanam pranama duksha samanam tang namami harim param. Anabriti Shabdat. The Shabda Brahma, when coming out from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vaishnav, you will have to try over and again to hear and think. You can cross over this material ocean. A sadhu cannot be confined within the limit of a country. There should not be any sectarian attitude. There should not be any, you know, society, you know, conception of society. A sadhu is international, open to all. A sadhu is hard. A genuine sadhu, his heart is crying for everybody. Even for an insect, what to speak about man and woman? What to speak about brothers? Why? I beg for pardon I beg for mercy from the lotus feet of Bhagavan Nityananda for all my god brothers and everybody. I have no jealousy, nothing. That's why Bhagavan can allow me to speak Harikatha. Otherwise, Harikatha not for some material sound can come. Try to understand. Try to understand the difference. Try to understand the difference between Sabda Brahma and material Sabda. Try to understand between the Sabda Brahma and Sabda Samanna, material sound and Sabda Brahma. Try to distinguish between these two things. Until and unless you are going to get Kripa from Guru Varga, you cannot understand. He can confuse. He can run towards wrong direction. Prabhupada speaking, suppose you discover that you are already in a wrong ten. Prabhupada speaking, suppose sometime you discover, well, I am in wrong ten. Then immediately you have to get down from the ten and you will have to catch right ten, which is going directly to the destination you mean. Prabhupada speaking. Many times it happens so. I was in hurry, nobody speaking, I jump and get the train. Then I see the train is running toward opposite direction. I jump from the train and get another train. In Bandel, it happened long ago, maybe 15 years back. One night, I was very busy, what to do? Without asking, I get the train, then running to a wrong direction, I jump from the train and get right train. So, Prabhupada speaking, suppose you discover you are already in a wrong ten. Nothing to do. Already you are in a wrong ten. So you have to get down from that wrong ten. You have to catch right ten so that you can reach your destination of Bhagavat Prema. It is not the question of sentiment. It is not question of fighting. It is a question of your life. So, Vyad Bhagavatamrita is such a thing. You know, Sukhdev Goswami describing. Top to bottom, Sukhdev Goswami speaking Bhagavatam, all Amrita. Still, Uttaradev is speaking well, but I have no time to hear all in detail. So, please, out of your own, you are already getting mercy from Sukhdev Goswami. Why not you try to collect the Amrita, the gist, of what you have heard from Guru Pad Padma. Very cleverly you will have to give me the gist. Now question is that in Bhagavatam from top to bottom there is nothing wrong. All Amrita. From top to bottom, top to end, all Amrita. But still, why this kind of comment we cannot bear? Then the argument is that we are going to give some consolation to you all. Well, Bhagavad is full of Amrita. There is nothing which we can avoid, but still, time is very limited. It's vital point, time is very limited. Now, anytime Takkak can come and bite, Parikshit Maharaj can go away from this material world. And he is left with very minimum time. And Uttaradevi at the same time putting question. Now, those who are commentator, they are speaking. The Bhagavatam, all, top to bottom is okay. There is nothing which we can avoid. But still, since the time is very limited, maybe Uttaradevi is bound to speak that way. Uttaradevi, that those who are Rasik Bhakta, those who are genuine Rasik Bhakta, those who are talented Rasik Bhakta, enjoying full kipa of Rup Sanatan, Jiva Goswami Pad, Guru Varga, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who can say? Their heart is always busy, their heart is always absorbed in Rasa Siddhanta Vichar. They are not Sahajiya. Their heart is always absorbed in rasa siddhanta vichar. So maybe their heart is always longing, they are always wanting, they are always, you know, want to hear all the loveful affair of Radha Govinda and Gopikas. Who can say? Who can say? So maybe this reason. Bhagavad is full of importance. Top to bottom, there is no doubt. But maybe this reason, the some rasik bhakta, they not feeling any inspiration, they not feeling any inspiration to go through other different kind of, you know, tattva siddhanta which are here, there in Bhagavatam. Though directly, indirectly, everything related with Krishna, not indirectly, all. Bhagavatam is totally the body of Krishna. Shakshat Krishna evahi. So maybe this reason. All rasik bhakta, they are always, you know, they are always absorbed in rasa siddhanta vichar. Maybe for them, all other siddhanta which are written there in Bhagavatam may be not suitable for them only. That doesn't mean Bhagavat, you know, this portion you should avoid. Not that. Maybe this reason. This way actually, Parikshit Maharaj going to describe very happily, and Parikshit Maharaj giving assurance. Parikshit Maharaj giving assurance, maybe, Parikshit Maharaj giving assurance, maybe somebody can think that time is very short, I am going to die, maybe I am nervous. For that reason, I cannot speak clearly. But not that. Now I am getting full kripa of my Gurupad Padma Paramahansa Sesha Sukhdev Goswami. No question of any nervousness. No question of any nervousness. I am not at all nervous. With cool brain and heart, by the mercy of my Gurupad Padma Paramahansa Sesha Sukhdev Goswami, surely, Mother, surely, Mother, surely, I can go on speaking about the Nectarian Harikatha, which can be treated as the gist of all Bhagavatam. You know, and all the way in our Harikatha, in our writing, we can come out successful. When Trinanda Vibhav is there, Anytime you can take secret information about pure Guru Vishnu. Anytime if you have some doubt about them, how they are leading their life. They are leading their life just like beggar. Just like a beggar with torn clothes, everything. They have everything. They like to lead their life this way. Somehow they manage their life. If you have any doubt about any pure Guru Vishnu, you can take secret information about how they are leading their life. Out of their humble attitude, they are leading their life like a dog. They think that I am the dog of my Guru Varga. Tumi to Thakur tomar kukur boriya janu hupore. You will have to sing the kirtan. Sarvasya tomar charone supiya parichi tomar ghare. Tumi to Thakur tomar kukur boriya janu humore. You will have to sing this kirtan. To develop humbleness. Humbleness doesn't mean I will have to avoid speaking absolute truth. Humbleness doesn't mean that I will have to avoid speaking absolute truth absolute way. The humbleness doesn't mean I cannot speak boldly. Humbleness doesn't mean sarvasya tomar charone sopiya parechi tomaro ghare. Tumi to Thakuro, tomaro kukuro, boliya jano humore. All we Gauriya devotees, all, not I myself, everybody, I myself sing, I am sitting in Vyasasan. What is my identity? I am the dog of my master, Gurupad Padma and Prabhupada. 100%, I promise you I am sitting in Vyasasan. My identity is I am the dog of my Gurupad Padma Guru Bhargava, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada. This is my identity. My faithfulness can prove. My faithfulness can prove that I have love for my Guru Bhargava. My faithfulness can prove that I have my love for my Guru Bhargava. Because all the 24 hours, I like to sing about Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all my genius Guru Bhargava. I like to glorify them. It's my duty. It is my duty all the time. And by all your blessings, I can go on singing up to my last moment of life, and I beg for that kind of blessing. But one condition set by Mahaprabhu. If there is no Trinadavi inside my heart, surely I cannot speak Harikatha. If there is no Trinadavi in actual sense, if there is no Trinadavi inside me, I cannot speak Harikatha. What do you mean by Trinadavi? Less interested to get Pratishtha. That is called Trinadavi. I am less interested to get Pratishtha from you all. I am less interested to get Pratishtha from you. You can kick me, you can abuse me, whatever you do. But you bless me so that I can go on, you know, singing about that absolute truth, absolute way. So that I can never fear speaking about that absolute truth. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking the condition. Who can sing the glories of Guru Bhargava and Bhagavan? Harikatha, who can speak? Tinada Vesana Chinnatarur Vesashina Amanina Manadina Kirtaniya Sadahari. Harikatha, Harikirtan, to be done under the mood of Trinadavi. If there is no Trinadavi, then all random Siddhanta. If there is no Trinadavi, be sure, like mathematics. If there is no Trinadavi, then random Siddhanta can come. Sometimes criticism, sometimes this, that. No harmony, no, you know, flow of Harikatha. Random Harikatha. So try to understand all symptoms I am speaking. You are hearing Harikatha, also you go through Harikatha of other people whom you respect, I don't know. And try to understand there is harmony or not. There is a topic or not. There is any depth of Siddhanta Vichara or not. There is any final conclusion or not. There is any submission unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada or not. There is one, then a submission unto the lotus feet of Sampradaya or not. Try to understand this one first. After that you go through Harikatha. Otherwise avoid hearing the Harikatha. Cannot give you benefit. So Trinadavi Sunijuna Tarurva Sashina Amanina Mandir Kitaniya Sadahari. This is the condition said by Mahaprabhu. So surely those who are not having any Trinadavi Bhava, those who are offender, doing Namaparad, Vaishnavaparad, abusing Vaishnavas, they cannot purify their own heart. How they can purify other? Because Namaparad there is Satang Ninda, Sadhu Ninda. You cannot criticize Sadhu. If you do, Harinam can never come to you. Then if you cannot clean your own heart, how you can clean other? How you can clean? If my Guru Maharaj's heart is not clean through Harinam, then how Guru Maharaj can clean me? Is possible? Impossible, like mathematics. Don't be foolish. Try to understand our Siddhanta Vichara. Don't be guided by some foolish conception. Now, Vishwanath Chakravarti is speaking the same thing. Like Mahaprabhu speaking, Trinadavi Sunitarava Sasana, Amanina Manadi Kitaniya Sadahari, almost same thing Vishwanath Chakravarti is speaking. In the Bhagavad Tika, Dinata Mano Dattyadi Sila Kiptoi Mahabriti. We have seen the humble attitude of Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami Maharaj. We have seen the humble attitude of Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, how talented and big, you know, devotee they are, eternal persons of Prabhupada. They never speak anything against any Guru Vaishnava, they speak Siddhanta Vichar. They are powerful. Dinata Mano Dattadi Sila Kliptai Mahabriti Bhakti Balli Nivi Panyaha Savanadi Mushonoi. Vishwanath Chakudi wanted to say Amani Manav. Amani Manav doesn't mean somebody doing Sampradaya Gapara, somebody doing Vaishnava Parah, somebody doing Siddhanta Aparad, speaking all like Chukli politics, I can say. Not that. Not that. It is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to speak fearlessly about our Siddhanta Vichar, because they like to protect all, you know, Sautra Pantha, everything. So if situation demands so, they can speak so heavily that it seems like criticism. It is not criticism. They are going to protect the future Sampradaya, present Sampradaya, you know, Vaibhav. You know, Vishwanath Chakravarti is speaking, Amani Manot. Amani Manot means Vaishnava, Bhakti Bhavat Puri Krishna, we have seen, always giving honor. Even Bhakti Bhavat Tutuva, we are giving so honor to him. His disciple was giving so much honor all the time. We have seen. Not that his disciples are what need of honor, no. Guru Padma, we have seen how much honor Guru Maharaj used to give to Bhakti Vallabhatitya Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, Santo Maharaj, how much honor, and with how humble attitude. Dinota Manadattadi Sila Kriptai Mahabriti. Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. If you are interested about Savan Kirtan Sauta Pantha, Vishwanath Chakravarti is speaking, if you are really interested about Savan Kirtan, how I know you are interested about Savan Kirtan? Then automatically you can throw everything and come. It's a symptom. Now the situation is so critical, nobody is interested to hear absolute truth. They are habituated to hear lie or Ravi Siddhanta. They are busy with glamour, position, rank, this. They are less interested. You know, less interested. They cannot hear. They can attend one international speaker. Though he is speaking lie or wrong Siddhanta. Whole life. So, dinata manadattadi sila kliptai mahabriti. Bhakti Ballir Nivhi Panyaha Savanadi Mushonoi. Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, if somebody really interested to hear Sasva Siddhanta, I mean those who are really interested about Savan Kirtan, for them it is the advice given by Vishwanath Chakravarti. Don't expect any kind of honor for anybody. Dinata. Dinata means humbleness. I am nothing. What I have done? Prabhupada speaking, all from south, you know, Bharat Sagar and up to Himalaya. I am trying my best, but I cannot find one man who is genuinely interested to hear all secret Siddhanta which are all against. They always try to make some contamination. Bhagavan, you come to me, but with some contamination you come. If you purely, if you come, I cannot accept you. So you come with some contamination. Bhagavan, mayamishye esho, mayamishye. With the compilation of some maya you come to me, otherwise they cannot catch you. A Bhagavan can never come with mana, together with maya. Bhagavan can never come to us together with maya. Impossible. jaha krishna taha nahi mayar adhikar. Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, is somebody really interested about Savan Kirtan? Amrita! Amrita, Savan Kirtan. Harinam Sankirtan as sung by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All different kind of infighting, all, you know, all kind of jealousy, all kind of, you know, narrowness can go away if we can sacrifice our life into the fire of the Sankirtan Jagyagni, which was started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, maintained by our Guru Bharga, ultimately totally maintained by Jiva Goswami Pad through Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha, all rubbish thing happening. Then there is some controlling. There should be controlling. There is no controlling. Everybody was saying, don't speak anything, Maharaj. Then how you can... Is somebody speaking wrong? Why you are speaking wrong? Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha can bring him. This was the system of Jiva Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad. Now nobody, everybody great Vaishnava. No, don't speak. Not speaking anything is a symptom of great Vaishnava. Not speaking, he is not speaking anything against anybody, so he is great Vaishnava. Because he is not speaking. And it is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. If Vaishnava not going to discharge his own duty, he is not at all Vaishnava. Fool is number one. Dinata Manadattadi. Pure Vaishnava never expect any honor from anybody. They are always leading their humble life like beggar. You come secretly and watch how they are leading their life. Just like a beggar. But when they are going to speak Harikatha, then like king, they can sit. This is the instruction of Prabhupada. You know, dinata manadattvadi sadgunai, all sadgun, different kind of good qualities like dinata, humbleness and giving honor to other, amani manad. This kind of humbleness is one kind of wall. This kind of humbleness can act as a wall all around your bhajan field. Otherwise, you can destroy your bhakti keeper and bhakti field. Everything. Dinata manadachadis silakriptvai mahabriti bhakti, bhakti balli. And the creeper of bhakti, you should give protection. Our Kesav Goswami are speaking. If you are failure to give protection all around your bhakti field, what is that field? What is that boundary? That is bhakti siddhanta boundary, acharan, etiquette. Why common people, useless people cannot come in front of me? Why? They fear. They cannot come. This is one kind of wall around them, around me. I can protect. I have no bhakti, but I can try to protect whatever I have. So Kesav Goswami was speaking, until and unless you are successful to make a boundary all around your bhakti field to protect your bhakti keeper, maybe some goat, some cow, buffalo can come and eat up the bhakti creeper. So you will have to arrange protection all around your bhakti field. That bhakti field is Siddhanta Vichar. That bhakti wall is Siddhanta Vichar and perfect acharan. Pure devotees, they have so power. Why? Why are they are speaking so heavily? Because they have their power. Their acharan giving their power. Their acharan giving their power. If anybody going against them, they can get lost. Anybody, you can try in your life. If anybody going against one pure Guru Vaishnava, they can just get lost in this infinity world. Nobody can trace out. Maya can grasp your heart. So, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, dinata, humbleness, and giving honor to others, This kind of all good qualities can be like a wall around the devotee. Like to Tulsidas ji, somebody coming and speaking, "Oh Tulsidas ji, that so-called bhakta," in front of Tulsidas ji, somebody coming, some sadhu speaking, that so-called sadhu speaking all rubbish against you. You know, Tulsidas ji Maharaj, you know, he is speaking all rubbish against you. Really so? Yes. So then I can beg Madhukuri and make one bhajan kutir in front of my bhajan kutir. Are you don't understand what I mean to say. You don't understand. He is criticizing you all the time. Oh ho! That's why I like to make some Madhukuri and make one bhajan kutir beside my bhajan kutir. So what? So he can go on. So he can go on detecting my. So he can go on detecting my fault, and I can have the chance to rectify my fault, and I can do my bhajan perfectly and go to Supreme Lord Ramji. Very nice Siddhanta. If you can go on finding fault with me, I am very happy. You criticize me. So many people in front of me writing letter, Maharaj, you are enjoying. I have letter, I can show you. If I express the name, then everybody can spit on his face. He is writing to me, "You are enjoying the full kippa of Guru Bharga. You are the support of all fallen souls of foreign countries." And now he is giving advice to somebody, "Don't go, Sambhava is offender." That's why whole society, whose society, who is mean? Prabhupada is alone. Prabhupada is alone Gauriya Vaishnava society. Prabhupada is alone Gauriya Vaishnava society. Keshav Goswami is alone Gauriya Vaishnava society. What do you mean? What do you mean by whole Vaishnava society? They are going to ignore the interests of Sampradaya. You are, "Oh, Sampradaya are going to avoid Baba." I like to avoid them. Very good. Otherwise I can lose my time. I have no time to waste, to speak rubbishly here and there, all giving and doing kind of criticism and, you know, politics. I have no time. No time I have. So this way, Keshav Goswami is speaking, if you are failure to make some wall around your bhajan field, then Bhakti Lata beach, Bhakti Lata is growing, then sometime some goat or buffalo or cow can come and eat up the Bhakti Lata, the kripa of Bhakti, and you can lose everything. Be careful about it. You can lose everything. So why not you make offensing of Siddhanta Vichar? Anytime anybody making Siddhanta Virod, wrong Siddhanta, Keshav Goswami like lion, giving answer. Like lion giving answer. This is called Acharya Sip. Acharya Sip doesn't mean I can prove that I am a big devotee, I cannot speak against anybody. No. You are merciless. You are not speaking Harikatha, you are not going to rectify the wrong Siddhanta, you are not going to give the reply to this criticism. You are not at all Acharya. Now we are going to start Brihad Bhagavatamritam. First word I can start, and I can start explaining next week Srimad Brihad Bhagavatamritam. Pratama khandam, pratama dhyaya, namaha krishnaya bhagavate radhika ramanayo. Sanatana Goswami Pad writing, jayati nijo padabjo premodana avatirno vivida madhuri madhi ko opi kaisaro gandhi gato paramo dasantam jasso chaitanya rupad Anubhava padam aptyam premo gopi sunityam. What writing? Jayati nijopad abjo premo dana matirno vibhido madhuri madhi kopi kaishara gandhi gato paramo dasantam. Jasso chaitanya rupad anubhava padam aptam premo gopi gopi sunityam. Follow what I say. Very nice, fantastic bandana. Glorification of the lotus feet of Gauranga. Glorification of the lotus feet of Gauranga. I can explain all in detail. Today I have no time. I can only speak something. That avatari, the Supreme Lord, who appearing in this material world in the form of Chaitanya Dev, who wanted to show the excellency of love, appear prema. He wanted to distribute his own prema, coming in the form of devotee. He wanted to give Krishna prema. He is himself Krishna. Wanted to come in the form of Krishna Chaitanya. Wanted his target was to distribute his own prema among, you know, devotees. With the ocean of Madhurima, with the ocean of beauty, Amrita, and who attaining the topmost, you know, Jahar Prem Param Dasar Charam, his Prem extending up to the last limit, which is going to show that those Gopikas, those Prema, Mahaprabhu wanted to expose in front of us. And Chaitanya Akya Sarup Vaite, from the Chaitanya Akya Sarup Charam Sima Prapto, the end point attained it. This Prem Sema are still not confined within limit. Gopi Prem, it has become an object of realization for us because of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And who is eternally adolescent age? Nitya Kaisara Bhushita Kono Ek Anirvachaniya, inexplicable. That Purush, that Mahapurush, Chaitanya Chanda, he is all glories to his lotus feet. All glories to his lotus feet. Jayati nijapadabjo prema danava tirna vibhido madhurimadhi kopi kaishara gandhi gato paramo dasantam jasso chaitanya rupad anu bhavapadam aptam prema gopishu nityam. Prema namad bhutartho savana pathagataho kasya namna mahimno ko betta kasya vrindavano vipino maha madurishu pavesha kova janati radham paramaraso chamatkar madhurja seema mekas chaitanya chanda paramakarunaya sarvam avish chakaraha. Follow. Bancha kalpaturvasya kipasendu bhavacha patitanam pavanu bhavashna vyo namo.